you just pooted on me. He still pooted. Hey YouTube, it's your girl Maja K, and I'm back with another video. So as y'all can tell by the title of this video, I'm gonna be doing a Q&A. I had asked some questions on Instagram and on YOLO. I don't know if y'all know that, but it's like for Snapchat. So yeah, I had asked some questions on there. So we just gonna be answering the questions today. Like, comment, and subscribe, and add me on Snapchat and Instagram. It's gonna be right there. Okay, so first, I'm gonna be looking at my other phone to answer the questions. But first, we gonna do Instagram. First, oh, I'm back. Oh, here they go. Here, this is the post I had made. Life of being a mom. My bad, y'all. He trying to eat cords and stuff. Just a moment. I'm gonna put his bib on. Say hey, YouTube. Say hey. Say hi. Say hi, Jimmy. The first question is, stop doing your stuff. Y'all see him. Is, what's your favorite color? My favorite color is black. I just love black. Like, as y'all can tell, I always put on black with anything. My next one is, what's my favorite food? I really don't got a favorite food, but wings or chicken or something. Somebody said you cute as fuck. Thank you. Another question. Well, I'm just gonna go in order. What inspired you to do hair? It's like if nothing really inspired me. I just wanted to do it, like, cause I seen all my, like, a lot of people in my family do hair. So like all my big cousins stuff was doing hair. So I end up just getting on YouTube one day and just, I was just playing around. I had my mannequin in the room with me, and I was just watching a video on YouTube, and then I learned how to braid and all that type of stuff. And then I just kept practicing until I got good. And now I love doing hair. Stop. Somebody said, why are we not together? Bit. No, but I just got out of a relationship. I ain't trying to get in a relationship right now. Like, it's just, we ain't gonna talk about that. Reaction when you found out you were pregnant. I was shocked. Like, I didn't know what to do. I was really shocked though. I was excited. I was scared. Happy, all that. Like, I feel like it was gonna ruin my life, but now it's like I'm getting so much accomplished with him. So it's like, nah, that ain't it. I just was happy. Next question is, do you still go to Jonesboro High? Yeah, I still go there. I do virtual though. Somebody said, you live in the P. I seen you at the, hold on, wait, I gotta go to the whole thing. I seen you at the Central game, you fine in real life. Thank you, but no, I don't stay there. I stay in Georgia. How would you call yourself right now? Do you feel like you're successful? Yes. I feel like I could have done better though, but I got a lot accomplished within like a month or two, because I end up like taking a break from certain stuff. So it's like I had end up getting behind, but now I'm back up, and yes, I feel like I'm successful. I said, how you doing? I'm doing good, as y'all can see. My baby, we happy. Okay, I'm gonna go answer questions on YOLO. Oh, I forgot. Okay, somebody said, what's your biggest turn off? My biggest turn off is hygiene. Like, you just gotta be up on your hygiene and stuff. Like, if you stink and all that type of stuff, like, okay, it's like, I don't really care if you, like, don't got money or you got money or stuff like that. Like, or materialistic stuff. Like, that's not what I look at. I just look at your personality, and if you're childish, nah, you're cut. Like, stuff like that. I don't know. But I'm childish myself, but it's just like certain things you just gotta, you know, gotta be going about. You just pooted on me. He still pooted. Junior, not on YouTube. I'm just playing. Your favorite cartoon character. I really don't got a favorite cartoon character. I don't know. Who I used to watch as a kid? Like, Dora. I used to watch Dora a lot. SpongeBob. Stuff like that. I don't know. I ain't got no favorite cartoon character. If a genie granted you 3 wishes, what would you ask for? First, I'll ask for my dad to be back alive, because with him being here, it would have just been so different. Now, when you just need your dad type stuff. Like, I miss him so much. Tell them what we wish for. I say good health. That way, like, I won't have to worry about my health or nothing. So I'll be healthy. I say to be highly successful and making a lot of money. That way, I won't have to leave for now, you know, or worry about nothing. So me and my baby can be straight forever, you know, type stuff. Another question is, what music do you listen to? I probably can show y'all my favorite. You okay? Look at you. I'm going to pin my music list on the screen, but here's the music that I like. But I'm going to put it on the screen too, so y'all can see it better. Because, yes, like, that's a lot of songs, but, like, I listen to a lot of stuff and a lot of different songs. So, you know, that goes one of my playlists. Your biggest insecurity. Well, it used to be, first it was my gap, and then when I got pregnant, it was my weight. But, but now I don't really have none. Like, I'm good. Like, I really don't have any. I don't have no insecurity, really. Look at him pulling my weight. If you see a guy trying to get his life together, would you fuck with him? Got a job, but working on getting more stable. It depends. Like, if it's somebody I already dealt with over and over, and they done put me through hell and back, and, you know, type stuff, then maybe not. But it depends on how it's going. But he always interrupting me. I can't never finish talking because he always want to talk. But another one is, what are your biggest goals to accomplish in life? To graduate and to be my own business owner, or be an entrepreneur and become a CNA so I could travel and, you know, go work in a nursing home all over the world. And to a good ass life for my son, so that he won't have to need for none or worry for nothing when he get old enough to, because he'll have it all already. Somebody said labor and delivery story, but I'm gonna do like a separate video for the whole story. I went to a doctor's appointment, and I just went there for a regular doctor's appointment. So I went there and my blood pressure was high, so they sent me to the ER, and then at the ER, like, they ran tests on me, they drew my blood and all that type of stuff. So then I was in there for about like week first. The first time I was in there for like a week, and that's when they diagnosed me with gestational hypertension. Because my blood, they were just running tests on me, and my blood pressure wasn't going down. So I'm gonna like put some here like of how it went, and just show y'all all the pictures of me in the hospital and stuff. They had discharged me from the hospital after a week of being in the hospital on some blood pressure, some high blood pressure pills. I think it was Labetalol. I forgot how to say it, but it started with an L. They had diagnosed, they sent me home with that. So after that happened or whatever, my feet was just getting like real swollen and stuff, and I started going to a high risk doctor. So my high risk appointment was, I think, that next Wednesday after I got discharged from the hospital. So when I went to the high risk appointment, they did the same thing they did with me with my regular OBGYN. After they did all that and stuff, like, my blood pressure was so high, and they end up running the test on me and stuff, like drawing my blood and stuff, and they end up diagnosing me with preeclampsia. That high risk, a doctor was already in the same hospital as where I was going to be having my baby at. So that day, it's like I was just going to a regular appointment, right? Whole time I had to get induced and I had to have my baby that day, and I didn't know. So they sent me upstairs, and basically I was just sitting there for like so long. Like, it was like a whole day before they induced me, and I was just sitting there for so long. They just had me hooked up to the IV, and they just kept coming to draw my blood. I don't know what to do, but I'm just so mad because like I wasn't ready for to be this early, and I wanted to vlog and show y'all everything. It was that Wednesday at 10 to 11 at night when he had finally induced me. And when they induce you, you can't eat, you can't do nothing. Like, you just gotta sit there the whole time, and they have to put the Foley in me. Like, you know, y'all, I don't know if y'all know what a Foley is. The pee hole attaches to that, and that's where they had to put it at. And it hurt it so bad. I was just crying, like, most of the time. Like, the whole time, I couldn't eat or I couldn't drink nothing for 3 days. Like, I was induced for 3 days. My baby was at a 6 until the last day. So, the third day had finally passed. And, like, the doctor just had kept coming back in a room, just, like, asking. I mean, not asking, but the doctor had kept coming back in a room and checking my son if I dilated yet. Third day, she had finally did it for the last time, and she was like, "You ready to push?" And I was like, "Yes." I was so happy because the first time they gave me the upper door was the day I had first got induced. So the second time they gave me the upper door was the last day, which was when he finally had came. And y'all, like, it hurt it so bad. I cried the first time when I had got it, but then the second time I was like, "I'm a champ. I gotta get this weapon," because I was not finna feel that pain. Because once you get an upper door, you don't feel nothing. Like, the whole time me pushing, all I was feeling was pressure. That's the only thing. So it was like so many people in the room. It was like 10 nurses in the room, y'all, because they knew my baby was gonna be premature and he was so small. So they just knew already. It was the NICU, and then it was a lot of nurses, and then it was anesthesia in there too. So three different departments had to be in a room with me. So like, I pushed for like, I think it was like 10 minutes. I'm not gonna show y'all the video, but I pushed for like 10 minutes. And he had finally came, and when he came out, y'all, he was like so freaking small. It was so shocking and scary. But he came out 5 pounds and 12 ounces. So then after that all happened, like, I only got to hold him for like 2 minutes, not even that. So they had to come up there to the NICU, and it's just like I was there alone because like my mom was there with me the whole time. Like, I got induced and stuff, but she also had two other kids, which was girls at home. She had to go to attend to. So I was there by myself that night, but my mom ended up bringing my cousin back, like, in the morning time. Yeah, because I had to stay there for another day. But my baby was there for over a week, y'all. That killed me. Like, I cried. But I went to the hospital with him every day. But, like, he was so small, y'all. I'm going to show y'all the pictures of how small he was. And look how big he is now. For him to be premature. What? But, yeah, y'all. So that's just a little bit of it, because I got a story to tell. But make sure y'all like and comment, subscribe, and make sure y'all like stay tuned with me, because I'm going to be dropping videos, you know. Look at my baby. You love me? Do you love you, mommy? You love you, mama? Because I love you. I love you so much.